The season of giving has allowed small businesses in the U.S. to flourish. Don Tagala tells us about Filipino-owned small enterprises.
Small businesses in the U.S. are in historic boom. Government data show America's 33 million small businesses are seeing expansion, with more than 14.6 million new business applications nationwide under the Biden administration. Among these new businesses are several Filipino-American-owned establishments found at the biggest holiday market in New York City. Chocolatier Daniel Corpus started his small business during the COVID pandemic with a goal of elevating Filipino ingredients such as calamansi, ube, and pandan through chocolate. Corpus's business continues to boom, 3 years into making and selling these bonbons, described as a taste of home in a Western form.
This season always is the best time of the year for what I do, diba chocolate, gift giving. And I'm glad to say that year over year, with the continued support of yung mga tao dito sa New York, at all across the Philippines, because I was recently there, you know, the business continues to grow.
SBA Chief Isabel Casillas Guzman says small businesses have a huge economic impact, accounting for 40% of the U.S. economy's output. Small businesses are also job creators, responsible for two-thirds of net new jobs that provides opportunities in local communities and help uplift the lives of people. That is why the Biden administration recently launched the Season of Small Business campaign to encourage more Americans to support small business.
Let's make the holidays the season of small business because they make our communities home.
For business owner Arnel Arrieta, as his Kuya Arnel's cooked longaniza and chicharron business thrived post-pandemic, he says he would rather place his products in other small businesses.
I'd rather sell sa 100 small stores kaysa magbenta ako sa 30 na malamang big stores. No? First, we're taking away yung businesses ng small businessmen. That's why I told them my heart belongs to the small businesses.
For Phil Ams here, expanding their business is another measure of their success. Calia Filipino Restaurant opened its doors in New York City's Lower East Side neighborhood last year. Today, with a booming business, Rob Maliari de Oria is getting ready to open up another restaurant in NYC.
We want to have another bigger space, and it will be a gastropub concept. So still Calia, still some of the products that we have here in the store, but probably more bar area and more of the traditional Filipino cuisine.
The SBA says investing in small business is crucial to build the economy from the middle out and the bottom up and not top down. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.
The San Francisco cable car rolls out its first ever Filipino Christmas-themed vehicle. ABS-CBN North America correspondent Henny Espinosa tells us what made the gesture more special.
San Francisco's iconic cable car got some special trimmings this year and is giving extra joy to Filipinos in the city.
Christmas is clearly the most important holiday for Filipinos, and here in San Francisco, Pasko Pilipino, or the spirit of Filipino Christmas, is clearly felt with this one-of-a-kind cable car.
Yeah, Pasko. That's my conductor, Andre.
Hi. Kamusta? Ayan o, maligayang Pasko.
For the first time in its 150th year history, the San Francisco cable car allowed for one of its vehicles to be all decked out in Philippine Christmas decorations as a special treat to the city's Filipino residents. Volunteers from the Filipino community took the time to decorate Cable Car 17 with dozens of paroles or Christmas lanterns of all sizes.
We use these capi shells. This ones I've had from my own house that I got from the Philippines when I went back home a few years ago. And then here you can see we also this parole. We added the Baybayin script that says Maligayang Pasko, that's custom made for us by this artist named Taipan Rosera based in the Philippines in Manila. And so this is like a Manila-San Francisco collaboration, especially for this occasion. And here we also have another parole decorated with Love the Philippines in celebration of the new Love the Philippines campaign being launched by the Department of Tourism.
What makes Cable Car 17 more fitting to be decorated with Philippine Christmas trimmings is that it was dedicated in honor of Filipino Reynaldo Morante, a dedicated cable car operator who was tragically struck in a collision while on duty in 2015. Driving a cable car that's dedicated in honor of his Filipino colleague is important for Celso Abueg, who has been in this line of work for close to 25 years. He was the first to drive Cable Car 17 after it was adorned with Pinoy Christmas decorations.
Proud, especially representing the traditions of Philippines, especially Christmas. And this is how they see how we celebrate Christmas in the Philippines. Ang Pasko sa Philippines. A lot of parole lights and everything.
At night, when the paroles shine bright, this group of Philams decided to catch Cable Car 17. They've been missing spending Christmas in the Philippines, and seeing Philippine holiday decorations on display in San Francisco is a way to ease their homesickness. Of course, they were beaming with Pinoy pride.
Yung ganda, yung pagkinang at pagkutikot-itap ng ilaw ng ating Pasko ay muling masasaksihan natin dito sa Amerika. Kaya definitely I'm excited.
Proud, actually proud.
Proud Pinoy.
Kasi I think parol is one of the symbols in the Philippines sa Christmas. So proud and at the same time, first time riding the cable car. So yeah, we're excited.
Me, us, friends, with everyone, it's exciting.
And as they ride through the streets of San Francisco, these Philams who feel the spirit of Pinoy Christmas hope to see more Philippine culture and traditions displayed all year round for the rest of the world to see. Henny Espinosa, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.
It's a busy Christmas weekend in Hollywood. There's a new Aquaman sequel plus an animated film and a musical. Our resident movie critic Manny the Movie Guy tells us his pick of the week.
Aquaman is now the king of Atlantis in the sequel, the final film in the DC Extended Universe.
King of Atlantis.
This one is more of the same. Everything is repetitive and derivative. In short, highly forgettable. Part 2 has so many behind-the-scenes problems that you can practically see them on the screen. The special effects are just okay, so is the editing. But some of the action scenes are good, and the cast tries to hold it all together. Aquaman, the franchise, started with a big splash and finished with nary a ripple. And for that, Aquaman and the Lost Kingdom gets 2 out of 4. Wait for it on DVD. Kisses. A better movie with brains and brawn is The Iron Claw. Zac Efron turns a career best performance as Kevin Von Erich, one of the Von Erich brothers who made history in the world of professional wrestling in the 80s. The title comes from the patriarch's death grip wrestling move. Efron is aided by a great supporting cast and writer-director Sean Durkin, a great storyteller who finds the balance between explosive wrestling action scenes and heartfelt family drama. Exciting and deeply moving, The Iron Claw gets 3.5 out of 4 World Wrestling Entertainment kisses. And for the entire family, there's Migration.
Here we are together.
From the studio that gave you the Despicable Me movies comes a film about a family of ducks who convince their overprotective father to go on the vacation of a lifetime. The first and last acts of the film are great, but the slow middle part may bore the little ones. But Danny DeVito as Uncle Dan is fun and funny.
Vibrant, colorful, fun. Yeah, lots of good stuff in it.
And for that, Migration gets 3 out of 4 Migrating Mallards kisses. And on Christmas Day, prepare for The Color Purple.
Ain't you got something to make you just smile?
This one is a soul-stirring musical that takes on Alice Walker's Pulitzer Prize-winning novel. The cast is superb, notably Fantasia Barrino as Celie and Danielle Brooks as Sophia.
You seem like trouble.
You still won't be able to forget Steven Spielberg's 1985 film. It looms large here, especially when the song and dance numbers cannot fully articulate the emotions needed for a dramatic scene. Still, this one pays homage to the original film while staying true to the spirit of the book. And that's why I'm giving The Color Purple 3.5 out of 4 Heaven Belongs to You kisses. I'm Manny the Movie Guy for ANC.
Another Filipino beauty queen has charmed the international pageant scene. The country's Beth Iliana Aduan has won Miss Earth Air 2023 after placing second in the recently concluded Miss Earth pageant in Vietnam. Aside from her title, Aduan also received the Best in Bikini Special Award. Meanwhile, Albania's Drita Ziri was proclaimed as this year's winner. Also part of so-called Elemental Court are representatives from Vietnam and Thailand, who won Miss Earth Water and Miss Earth Fire, respectively.